Krishna Padaya, Krishna Padaya. Thank you. And this is called Archana. Everyone has a tendency to give something in charity. Krishna says, give it to me. This means that all surplus money accumulated should be utilized in furthering the Krishna consciousness movement. Nowadays, people are very much inclined to the meditational process, which is not practical at this age. But if anyone practices meditating on Krishna 24 hours a day, how many hours a day?
24 hours.
How many hours?
24 hours.
How many?
24 hours.
24 hours.
Very good. By chanting Hare Krishna,
Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Round on the beats. Yes. He is surely the greatest meditator and the greatest yogi, as substantiated by the 6th chapter of Bhagavad Gita. Thus ends the Bhaktivedanta Swami translation purport. Srimad Bhagavad Gita, as it is in the matter of the most confidential knowledge. Chapter 9, text 27. Bhagavad Gita. Whatever you do, whatever you eat, whatever you offer or give away, whatever austerities you perform, do that, O son of Kunti, as an offering to me. How many of you are doing something? Did you do something in your life? You have some activity?
Yes.
Who is doing something? Right. Only those who are doing something, they should do it for Krishna. Should do everything for Krishna. But what is the Bhagavad Gita, the 3rd chapter, say, yagyata kamano yatra lokayam karma bandhana. Whatever is done for the sacrifice, for the pleasure of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Whatever you eat, do it as an offering for Krishna. So this is the thing, this is so much what we can do. Many things for Krishna. I don't know if you can do now more for Krishna. But if you're a child, maybe you have an excuse. But you have to name each of the little players after different avatars of Krishna. The Krishna avatar, just bring them all back to Godhead. Bhakti Churu Maharaj is now setting up a cell in Ujjain. I just saw some news about it, called Veda Games. they're trying to write computer games based on Mahabharata, Vedas, so that the children who are too much addicted to computer games, they can have a Krishna conscious game. Good luck. Interesting. Anyway, there's so much out there. Why not something of Krishna? The idea is we should do everything somehow connected to Krishna. We do this with our intelligence. We connect it with the intelligence. That's why this process is known as Bhuti Yoga. If we can connect our activities to Krishna, then by doing so, we will get closer and closer to Krishna. We're reading in the Srimad Bhagavatam how when Krishna went to Dwarka from Hastinapur after the Rajasuya sacrifice, after Yudhisthira was established, after Kunti offered her prayers, after Yudhisthira requested that Krishna spend some more time, so finally Krishna had to go. He had to go. His family and his other things he has to get just always in his Hastinapur. So when Krishna left, then Yudhisthira, Kunti and Draupadi and all the Pandavas and the other the wife of Kripacharya, a different, what was it, Kripacharya's wife of Brahmacharya, different illustrious people, they were there around Krishna, but also many hundreds of relatives of Krishna, distant relatives who were also living in the palace of Hastinapur, these ladies came out and they were crying. They were crying because Krishna was leaving. But they didn't want to cry because they thought maybe it's not fortunate for Krishna if they cry at the time of his departure. So they're trying to stop crying. But they can't because they love Krishna so much that they can't stop crying. So they're wiping their tears away. So Prabhupada said, you see, these people, they're not like, of course, Kunti and Draupadi and Arjuna and Yudhisthira. They were very intimately connected to Krishna, talking with him, eating with him, embracing him. But these ladies, they were not so much close to Krishna. They couldn't get that kind of association. But they also loved Krishna. They wanted Krishna to be with them. This is a big problem. So sometimes all the disciples want the Guru to spend more time with them. But he has to go other places and do other things and see other disciples. So how do you please everyone? You see, that's the difficulty. What to speak of Krishna? He's Jagat Guru. So everybody wants him to be there with them, but then he has to go from one place to the next. So Prabhupada said that because these ladies were hearing about Krishna, talking about Krishna, Sravanam, Kirtanam, Smaranam, remembering Krishna, Krishna had become very dear to them. So this is actually our process. This is what we do. We talk about Krishna. We listen to his glories. We remember them. By doing that, just by knowing about Krishna and hearing about him, how wonderful he is, we are in a very fortunate position to be part of Sanatana Dharma. Because Vaidic Sanatana Dharma has information about Supreme Personality of Godhead, about Parameshwara. The many religions that are worshipping the Supreme Lord, but they don't have so much information about him. You know, he's generous, kind, loving, merciful, beautiful, charitable, powerful, all-knowing, all-pervasive. You know, general things like that, but actually what does he look like? What does he do? We know some things. Like when Krishna came to leave the first time, Kunti Devi offered her prayers, and we have that prayers of King Kunti, beautiful prayers. Beautiful prayers by that illustrious Queen Mother of the Empire of the World. Very special spiritual lady in so many wonderful realizations. Very humble, very qualified. But when Yudhishthira came, he couldn't even speak. He's stuck. He's he couldn't speak. He just broke up to Krishna. You gotta stay a few more days, please. Don't go. And because he had so much love for Krishna, Krishna reciprocated. Ushdvacha. Because he had so much love for Krishna, that Krishna, that he couldn't say no. Now we can put on a show, but actually Yudhishthira felt that. He had so much, when we will feel so much love for Krishna, Krishna also, he will come to us, Prabhupada said. He'll stay with us. But how do we get that? Yeah, we get that by serving Krishna, by doing what this verse says, by eating his prasada, by hearing about him, by remembering him. If we do that, we start to get attached. Krishna is great. See, why is it that many people, they don't have that attachment to Krishna? You can't blame them. They haven't heard about Krishna from a devotee. They heard about Durga, they heard about Shiva, they heard about Skanda or some other illustrious Deva, Vishnu, Ram. They didn't hear, sometimes they don't hear about Krishna from the proper authority, or they hear something speculative or wrong interpretation. So that faith in Krishna doesn't establish itself. When Lord Chaitanya was traveling in South India, he went to a place called the Srisaila. That's where Andhra Pradesh is. Srisaila. The famous Shiva Tirtha there. So he went there and there he met Shiva. And the two of them were discussing what they would Shiva and Lord Chaitanya discuss. Politics? What do they have in common? What do they want to discuss? Anyone know? Huh? So who? Yes, they were discussing about Krishna and devotion to Krishna. Vaishnavan Jatha Sambhu. But Shiva's greatest devotee. And now Krishna himself come as devotee, meeting with Sambhu, the great Vaishnava, Acharya, great Mahadev. They're talking about Krishna. You read in Purana so many times when Shiva is telling Parvati about Krishna, about Vishnu. So they embraced each other and they're sitting and they're talking about Krishna in great ecstasy. Well, when Lord Chaitanya was going to Sri Saila, he stopped by the house of a Brahmana. And this Brahmana, he was a Rambhakta. So there's lots of Rambhaktas in Andhra Pradesh. Ram is very popular, also Narasingadev, and of course Balaji. Many of them, they don't know that Balaji is a form of Krishna. Bala means youth, youthful form of Krishna. Srinivasam Govindam. Govindam.
Govindam.
Govindam.
Govindam.
So, with this Brahmana, he's always saying, Rama. If he wants to offer you like some prasadam, Rama, Rama. More, Rama. Rama, Rama.
Rama, Rama.
Everything was Rama. So Lord Chaitanya said that you're always chanting Rama. The Brahman Sannyasi is my Ishta Devata. He's my worshipable Lord. So why don't you chant the name of Krishna? And this Ramana, he had a habit. He loved the holy name. So he had collected slokas and he said, yes, I know that. In the Shastra it says, Shastra Nama to the beast, Eka Rama Nama Varanadi. That if you chant one name of Ram, it's equal to the thousand names of Vishnu. And in South India, many people like to chant Vishnu Shastra Nama. But if they say one time, Rama!
Rama!
That covers all thousand. Raghupati Raghava Racha Raghupati Tapavati Raghupati. So how many thousands of names of Vishnu? But still some people, they rather chant Sarsana. But the Brahman also said that I also know in the same Padma Purana, Shiva told to Durga, to Parvati, that the name of Krishna is equal to 3,000 names of Vishnu. I know that Krishna's name is more powerful. But that's by logic and reason. But my heart is with Ram. Sita Ram Jaya Sita Ram. Sita Ram Jaya Sita Ram. Many verses that say that Krishna's name is more powerful, but I am too much attached to Rama. Just only his name comes in my mind. So, the Lord is not, it's okay. It's alright. Ram is also a form of Krishna, partial form. Then he met Lord Shiva as he saw Ram. Then he came back again and he stayed at the same Brahmana's house to take his meal. We sannyasis were not supposed to cook so much. Sometimes for Krishna we have to cook. So sometimes grihasthas are cooking for us. Grihasthas that are cooking for me today? For lunch, who cooked for lunch?
Seven Matajis.
They're not raising their hands.
All raise your hands to cook for Guru Maharaj.
These two are here.
Three.
Thank you very much. Very nice prasad. And special diet, low salt, ogi, some days low protein, some days low carbohydrate. Only non fat, frozen yogurt. Hard to cook. Hard. Easy to cook with lots of meat and lots of sugar and lots of. To cook something nice without much. But I do take spices. Some of our Western gurus are not like spices, but I'm an Indian guru.
So.
So sometimes we had to, sannyasi go to eat in the house of the grihasthas. I went with Prabhupada to many grihasthas' house to take prasadam. So like the Lord Chaitanya was going, he stayed again in the same Brahmana's house to take prasadam. This time the Brahmana was chanting, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Lord Chaitanya said, how is it possible? You're only chanting Ram's name, now you're chanting Krishna's name. He said, I don't know, I see, it must be you. I could never change. Even I knew intellectually that it was good to change, but I couldn't change. But by your association, by hearing from you about Krishna and your association, suddenly I just could chant Hare Krishna. It became natural. So I suspect that maybe you're Krishna in disguise or something, and that by your association, somehow you awaken my devotion for Krishna. Of course, it's the truth, that's who Lord Chaitanya is. He is Krishna in disguise as his own devotee. So when Lord Chaitanya would go around, he would awaken people's love for Krishna. Like that. We want that you all become so much Krishnaized. That all the, you are all Mahayogis, Bhakti Yogis, but you're disguised as householders and housewives and mothers and fathers and businessmen and engineers and lawyers and doctors and accountants and so many things. But that's all temporary, superficial bodies. But your eternal quality is you are a pure devotee of Krishna. And by your association with other people, you can awaken their devotion, their dormant devotion to Krishna. Because that's how, without that association, it's very difficult for many people to feel that same attraction to Krishna. Because you have such a nice association here, people come in the association. They start hearing about Krishna, start chanting Krishna's holy name, they start eating Krishna prasadam. Start reading Bhagavad Gita and Srimad Bhagavatam, chanting the Vishnu Sahasranam and the Ram Nam and the Krishna Nam, and associations of words, and they get changed. That's a miracle. Krishna is like an infection. But it's a good infection. It's like in our body we have the antibodies. The positive antibodies, the friendly flora and bacteria in our stomach. It's like yogurt, daheen, and they produce, they help to come in. If we don't have it, we cannot digest food. Any of you ever took antibiotics? After taking antibiotics, you find your digestion is very bad. Because you kill not only the bad bacteria, but the good ones, the friendly ones. So your digestion becomes really poor. So they give you some acidophilus, corydophilus, different kinds of bacteria cultures to help to bring up. Now they have what they call antioxidants. Friendly ingredients in the body which take away all the negative things from our body, the pollution, the poisons, and bring them out. We work, we can oxidize our body, we get rusty. Take all that stuff out, we need antioxidants, something like that, I'm not sure. Some very basic concept, not an expert in these things. So, just some crude example that like this, Krishna consciousness is a positive thing, but we need to get infected by it, we need to come in contact. That's what Srila Prabhupada was doing. As he traveled around the world, he was only a few days in Russia, but he met one Russian youth. Gave him initiation, Santi. Gave him the Santi something, gave him the name, gave him initiation, instructed him. Shama Sundar Prabhu, who was his secretary, said, what I hadn't learned in years, Prabhupada was intensively training him because it was Soviet Union in 1971. And from that one person, so many people became Krishna conscious. Now there's lakhs and lakhs of devotees in the former Soviet Union. So we heard even this in one small place like Kazakhstan. Bhakti Vrinda Govindavan is doing some impressive activities. Big land project. Yes, I visited Siberia to shoot. I was 30 miles from the Kazakh border, the Altai region in Siberia, for one festival. There were hundreds, maybe 400 or 500 devotees, all with tilak, some with saffron, some mostly with white, ladies in saris, Russians. Then I asked them, how many of you live in a temple? No Somebody raised their hand and I asked again, if I thought my translator is not translating properly. How many of you live in our temple? I asked 2-3 times and then one devotee raised hand and she said, Swamiji, Maharaj. There are no temples in Siberia. Only one temple, there's one temple. That's in Novosibirsk. That's about 2,000 miles from here, 2,000 kilometers. And it's a very big place. Siberia is spread out. Big cities scattered. And in that temple, there's 5 devotees who live, and none of them came for the festival. So in all these other cities, they have Sitoms, Oms, Barnaul, and then others, but each of those cities, there's hundreds of devotees, maybe 500 or more. But they have a Namhata, they have Bhakti Riksha groups. They have a structure where they don't have a temple, but they rent a hall and they come together. They don't have the money to buy in such a big place. There are so many devotees. So, in the future there will be some wealthy people who will help to offer temples and all these things. Now they're trying to make temple in Moscow. You ever seen the Moscow project? Might have the video on the CD. See, check. I think Aiken took all my CDs for some reason. But if we have that. Very ambitious project. The government gave them a property worth $16 million in downtown Moscow. And a lot of pressure from the local religions there, or religion, to block it. They want to build this Krishna temple for all the Hindus and for all the Russians, for everybody. They have at least one. It's a very big temple in Moscow or in Russia because although they're friends of India. So they're trying like that. So yeah, there's a lot of interesting things going on. But Prabhupada, he met the one person. So even a little bit of association can make a big difference. I met a person, he said he was chanting 16 rounds, was asking to get initiated. Then he told me that so many years ago you came one time, you asked me to chant one round, one mala of Hare Krishna. I started to chant. Now I want to be initiated and then 16 rounds. One time I met one person said, I've been chanting for 16 years, one mala. You told me to chant one mala, can I chant more now? It's a minimum one mala, you can always chant more. I didn't know, I disobeyed the guru. So we want to give that association. So that's how Grihastha is not Janvasi. You do everything for me. Jantanasi, you give everything away to me. As a Grihastha, you can invite people to your house and give them prasadam. So you give it. as a host, giving your family members prasadam. So that's part of offering to Krishna, giving to Krishna. By using your position in society, one of our devotees from the Middle East went back to her village or small town in Bengal. So in that town, here she's okay, I mean she's a well, her husband is a good job, he's a manager and all that. And when she goes back there, she's like aristocrat. Somebody coming from Middle East, wealthy family, nice house. So normally these kind of people are expected to be materialistic people. Supposed to have lots of money and be enjoying life. And she comes back and preaches to everybody, chant Hare Krishna. She established about 8 Bhakti Riksha groups. And there's hundreds and hundreds of people chanting. I just went there. In Mashinabad. And so many people were glorifying her. One leader of the Communist Party came and told me, he said, look at, what can I do? If a lady like this, who's got everything materially that people want to have, if she tells us we have to chant Hare Krishna to be happy, what can I do? I have to chant. Simple people, so they can be not so difficult as in the big metros. We just had a very nice program, and so many, they all gave me their reports. Teaching is going very nicely. So, that was, of course, we have already some preaching, but that was boosted a lot. Like one person spending a little time on vacation to go around and hold programs. You have to go and see your relatives, but while you're seeing the relatives, why not get everybody in the neighborhood to chant Hare Krishna? It takes a little bit, you have to be quite convinced, isn't it? But like that, someone can use their position. You don't have to give it up. We're not saying give up your family, give up your wealth, give up your position, give up. I mean, we're not saying this, we're not, our giving up is not the process of bhakti yoga. It's called yukta vairagya. Use it for Krishna. Whatever Krishna gives you, whatever you have, that's your host. Use it for Krishna. Whatever you're doing. Yajas, you're going to be giving away to do something for Krishna. Of course, if you're living in a society, they may come and say, we want donation for the local deity, puja, this thing. Something, a little bit you have to give, but that's just, you know, the social kind of obligation. But primarily you're giving for Krishna. Any major charity and thinking how I can, whether it could be in your building a temple in your house, in the neighborhood, or do some project like Mayapur or Moscow, whatever. Yeah. Snasi, whatever we eat. That's really important. The month of Damodar. We were eating really tough for those who follow. Because that month, no word dal. Especially if you're a South Indian, it means idli dosa. I think they suffer more. I had to go when I was in Malaysia, so we learned how to make dosas using chickpea flour. It's not the same, but anything is something. Chickpea flour, moong dal, green dosa, yellow dosa, ragi dosa. Ravana month is over now, you can take your normal dosa. Swami did it. But these little restrictions, the Chaturmas said, they help us just to remind, okay? Maybe very small things, 1 month no milk, 1 month no yogurt, and it's... We're eating for you, Krishna. We respect these little restrictions. And so is Krishna, love me. I'm eating for you. I'm eating your prasadam, and I'm eating what you want me to eat. We do 5 days in Bhishma Panchak. This year we had 250 devotees. Usually I lose some weight during that fasting. This year, because we have so much dry fruit from the disease. Well, I stay the same. But it was very cleansing. Just eat fruits for 5 days. Go every day to the Ganges and offer tarpana for Bhishma Day. Krishna has given mercy to Bhishma Day. He's a great devotee. I was thinking that sometimes, you know, people think that, well, if I take up Krishna consciousness, I'll lose something. Something in my life which I'll lose, so therefore, because I don't want to lose anything, Krishna consciousness might be too restrictive for me, therefore, I won't take it out. So, Bhishma Day, he also took a vow for a higher purpose to be a brahmachari, a janma brahmachari name. He was brahmachari his whole lifetime, didn't he? Never got married. He was a celibate. Even though he wasn't a renunciate, but he was a celibate. So it's very big austerity. She has no issue. No children, no grandchildren. Who's going to do tarpana for him? Who's going to do the srad? You're a grihastha, so your children are supposed to perform pindi or srad for you after you leave your body. They offer tarpana when they go to the Ganga, Jamuna, some holy river, Tungabhadra, Kaveri, Brahmaputra. So they offer the tarpana. So, we're all offering tarpana for Bhishma Day. I think how there were thousands of people, all the millions of devotees performing Bhishma Panchaka for the 5,000 years, offering tarpana to Bhishma Day. Of course, you don't even need it, in one sense. He's already saw Krishna at time of death, he went back to Krishna. He's the avatar of the Vasu. Still, anyway, in case somebody thinks, well, they may not have that kind of faith, but everyone's doing tarpana for him. Somehow, it touched me that Krishna made this arrangement for his devotee. Okay, for dharma, you didn't get married. No one is there, no issue for to do the tarpana for you. Okay, so I'm making arrangements. So somebody, millions of people are doing tarpana. Yoga kshema baham yaham. You preserve what you have and give what you lack. So Prabhupada said, he took sannyas at 59. He had wife and children. It's a big decision. Took vanaprastha at 56. So sometimes people also hesitate. Oh, so if I take sannyas, who will take care of me in my old age? some feelings are like that. So then Prabhupada, he mentioned, you know, that this is a concern many people have. And maybe if I had stayed home with my children, I don't think they can treat me so nicely as what you're all treating me. You're giving me so much love and affection. If I'm not your physical father, I'm your spiritual father. So like that, especially there's no loss. But we're not pushing that people should be renounced in a drastic way. Some people might fit in with this. Some widows. Different things happen. Families are very unconducive. But if there's a very favorable condition, everybody, we want the whole family rather to get ready, like a fortress. In the Srimad Bhagavatam, in the park by Priya Vrata Maharaj, Brahma, and Sarvabhu Manu, they describe that if husband and wife are both Krishna conscious, and they're both serving, they're both spiritually oriented, and they're doing their household duties as offerings to Krishna, then their house becomes like a fortress, protecting against Maya. So if you're a renounced order, means you have to fight against Maya alone. So one man battle, one person battle. Where in a family, if both are helping each other, then it's a team effort. So team effort in Kali Yuga, you're stronger. It's a family in Kali Yuga. It's not mentioned, it's not recommended to be renowned, to be in a renowned order. It's rather recommended to be Vihasta. But a Krishna conscious Vihasta. So sometimes it's said that one member is Krishna conscious and the other member is not so much inclined. What to do? You have to patiently try to give the other partner Krishna consciousness, give some prasada, pray for them. I mean, even Kaliya was against Krishna, but later he got purified. So it may take some time to get purified. Kaliya had a rapid, Krishna was dancing on his head, all the pounding from Krishna's feet on his head. He was simultaneously getting purified by Krishna's feet. He was also knocking out the poison from him. He was a very envious snake. Sita was very envious. He found everyone, even Krishna. So by getting kicked by Krishna's dancing feet so many times, finally he got purified and all that poison was out. The Naga Patnis were praying, please forgive our husband and bless him. So at the end of the day, Kaliya became a great devotee. He became a great devotee. He, because he has the footprint of Krishna on his head, Kaliya was hiding from Garuda. Because Garuda kept trying to catch him. So in Vrindavan, Garuda won't come. That's why he was in Vrindavan. But now Krishna told him that you should, you have nothing to fear because now you've got my footprint on your head. So now you're protected from Garuda. Some people say that he went to Fiji. Anybody here from Fiji? So wherever Kaliya is, there's no snakes. He scares away all the other snakes. So in Fiji, there's no poisonous snakes. So there's a deity they made in a Fiji island. Hare Krishna.
No.
So anyway, I hope that all of you continue the very sincere efforts you've been showing, chanting Hare Krishna, to become very spiritually strong, so that by your association, you can make other people Krishna conscious. Your family members, your friends, your work colleagues, neighbors, relatives, people you come in contact with. Thank you very much. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna,
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna.
I don't know. Is there any questions? First let's do this one. There's a Vaishnava way to do Shraddha. When we offer the Tarpana, we offer the Tindi, we do all those things using Vishnu mantras. That's the way you should do it. Offer Vishnu Prasad to the forefathers, the deceased forefathers. Vishnu Tarpana. Those mantras are Mayapur, our pundits, they have all those mantras they can give. Mahatma Maharaj has also. I may or may not have anyone chooses. You should never offer prasadam of devas or non-veg the forefathers. Some people do non-veg feasts and offer them. It's like sending them a package of sin. Here, dear forefather, accept this. You want to send them a package of spiritual blessings in case they're stuck up in some negative situation. They get a boost. Maybe they're suffering some Supreme Court case, or some heavy disease, or some hellish birth. Send them a package of Vishnu Prasada. Everything becomes okay. I become Krishna conscious. Yeah, in the house.
Where?
Will do.
You
don't do it, will do. There's a big joint family. Just a move to the family. Sure, the Prabhupada didn't say that. Don't go to a Dhamma program specifically, but he informed us that tradition was like that, and they would often stay in their homes traditionally. But in the modern circumstances, people are more active. They have whatever napkins and things. But generally they're not supposed to go on the altar. Usually they come Sometimes it depends on different families, they have different. Sometimes you forget, you don't have a folio, you can see all the things from what's said. I know how it's practiced, that they're not so strict in the West. But they don't usually cook or worship the deity at that time. But generally they still come to the temple. That's how, because in some cases where there's some emergency, then Prabhupada said an emergency, there's nobody else, then you can have me, they'll do this, other services which nobody won't do. Because in some of our temples there might have only been one priest. Some temples maybe it was a lady priest. In the West. And she didn't do the service and the lady would go on served. So then he said, well, emergency knows no rules. Especially if the Nam have meetings in their own house. When they're going to work, right? People go to work and everything else. And take off from work and go in that Kali Yuga. Unless someone has a very great illness. They're mainly just restricted from doing things which require one to be very suchi, like cooking and deity worship. In the house, just like you have to cook for your children. If the children are hungry, you have to feed them. Whether you're suchi or unsuchi. So there's no one, I know in some families the husband might cook for a few days, give his wife a break. But some places it's not possible because the husband doesn't know how to cook. But he also has a job. So she has to go and do those things. I said in India where it's more traditional and there's more joint families and it's even more of a luxury than to be able to.
Thank you for watching our videos. Be sure to subscribe to our channel. We publish new videos every day, and don't forget to like and share our channel.